All right, guys. Welcome back. Shadecrest Unleashed. And you might be wondering, just where are we? Well, we are still in the Promised Land. And why have we cleared this out? It's official. We're moving the base to the Promised Land. Oh, yeah. Good times, good times. New buildings, new all kinds of stuff. I'm not going to start a new season because it's basically the same map, and I'm going to move things from the overworld into here. And got a few new things to show you. As you can see, we've been busy. And let's get my helmet back on. All right. So, I took this hammer here and cleared out this room, laid in some loftwood logs up there, and we did a little layout work to figure out where we want to place everything. So we built this little area here, and we're going to put the ME controller or ME system in here and have all of our storage area in one location instead of all messed up like it is now. Man, this place is awesome, isn't it? This is the Tinker's Construct glass, and this is the Vibrant Quartz glass. It even gives off light. If it didn't have those bars right there in the middle, it'd be the best glass in the game. But anyway, look at that view. We got a view now. We have a view for sure. For sure, for sure. If we go on up here, and we started to lay out bedrooms for my buddy I Will, and my room. I did a little bit of vine work. And off here at the back. What do you think about that? I like it. I gotta put the glass in there yet, but there's the ME controller system in there. Here's where we are. I added these vines out of the loftwood leaves. And looks like some of them are despawning. Yeah, a big bunch of them have despawned already. So I might have to ask the admins to add disable leaf decay and redo this. I just noticed that. So this is I Will side of the map, and you can see down here we have a little bump out. Now what do we have out here? Okay, well, up here I'm gonna move all of our geothermal generators into here. We have an MFSU there. Be able to close this off and hide them all and be nice and neat. And up top, we have made some solar panels. Now we're going with the solar arrays. These are 6 medium voltage solar arrays, and we're working on getting 8 to make a HV. So there's that, and then this world is eternal day, so it's the ideal place for a solar panel. It's constantly working. So maybe after a while we can get rid of the lava generators, but for now it's pretty good. So into here, this little walkway, as you can see, there's something over here. But let's do this. Hello? Oh, I missed it. No, I clicked it twice. There we go. What do you think about that? I put some vibrant glass in here, and these are the drawbridges that we had. And camoed them with skystone. And this is, we have a drawbridge now. And in this island right here, is, well, it's kind of ugly, kind of derpy, but it's because I made it by hand. I tried to get it to blend in a little bit, but yeah, whatever. It's hard to make an island when you're bouncing up and down like this the whole time, but it's as good as I can do by hand. And what are we going to do with this island? Well, we are going to move the Tinker's Construct smeltery right here. We'll move our 2 villagers we got and all the chests and everything with it. And this is where we'll go to do our smelting. Any of our Tinker's Construct out here. in the wide open. Why is that? Well, this world does not spawn your typical overworld mobs. So far, all I have seen is Thaumcraft wisps flying around here. I have not seen... I know for a fact it doesn't spawn vanilla mobs. I have found some of the slime islands, the floating islands, so we might accidentally find some mobs there. But for all intents and purposes, mobs should not be spawning anywhere in this world. At least, yeah, no. I think the only thing that actually spawns here and is only from here is pixies, and I have yet to see a pixie. So, I don't know. Elusive little creatures. So I'm going to go back to the regular base here. Check it. Bow! This place is just falling apart. Oh my god. Anyway, one thing we can't do in that promised land, is make a nether portal. So the nether portal will have to remain here, and the old house will have to remain here, and we'll just leave it like it is, make it look like a ghost town, I guess. Just like, what happened to everybody? Where'd they go? Might as well get the XP while I'm here. Ouch! Ow! Quit it! I did move some loftwood trees here and some flowers and stuff just because. Oh, my purple trees grew. Anyway, let's go down to the basement and get our smeltery. You see, I took the drawbridges out of here. Okay, so first thing, I want to get this. And these are fairly full, so I'm going to get the force wrench to get those. I didn't think about that. La-dee-dee, force wrench, where you be? Oh, you know what? While we're here, I got to get rid of some stuff. I got all kinds of crap on me. Does that ever happen to you guys when you start building, you grab everything? Next thing you know, you've got everything of everything. You don't need half of it. Happens to me all the time. I wish I had a hot bar as big as the screen. I swear. We're going to be slowly moving this a little bit at a time because I think everything is still... No, it's not. What about... Oh, yeah. No. Everything must be kind of paused right now. Yeah, everything's kind of paused. We have so many silicone. Oh, we're only down to one. Okay. What's he got in here? Nothing? Anywho, I thought we had process still going for solar panels, but I guess not. Yep. It's wrenched that one. No. Shift. There we go. Now those don't stack, so I have to keep room for that. There we go. And we're gonna end up, let's see, wasting. Well, maybe not. I thought we was gonna end up wasting some lava, but I guess not. Alright, start picking it up. So I'm gonna get this stuff here picked up and get back over to the base, and I'll catch back up with you in just a bit, guys. So see you in a second. Okay, guys, we're back. I love that bridge, man. That is awesome. So I guess you guys remember how I need to set this up, but I'm not going to explain how to do it. Excuse me. I was whistling while I was talking. So what do you guys think about this place? Man, this is just... this is just amazing, man. One thing I didn't show you guys was this little space we have underneath there that is... it's just so beautiful. We're going to have to do something special underneath there. Put these in the corners here. I did not want to do that. I wanted to set it right on top. I'm probably going to have to make some of this seared stone. Some more, I should say. Okay. I'm not leaving a space underneath here for any particular reason, but I just wanted to bring this up by one this time instead of having everything in the floor. Oh, I don't want to do that. Let's see. Come over here. Get rid of that. Pick those up. Now let's trade. There we go. Okay, so that would go up there. Change that out with some sky stone maybe later or something. Give a nice contrast, a nice black-white contrast. Oh, man. So we have some pretty big plans for this particular world, I guess you could say. One of the things that we're looking at, which I think is just going to be so awesome, is our buddy I Will is going to look at making some trains using the Steve's card or the... I think it's what that... stuff is Steve's card, isn't it? Some of the... well, I guess not. I don't know. I don't know nothing about it, but he does. He's going to make some trains going back and forth between the islands and make, like, a scenic railway. That's going to be so cool. I can't wait for that to get done. I'm going to go ahead and put that there. That there. Nope, not you. Where'd my axe go? Oh, there it is. Okay. I thought I lost it. Oh, this dirt, man. It's so easy to break with a pickaxe. It can be a little annoying. But we got it. Okay, so if you remember, in this bottom row, we need the controller. Yep. Smeltery controller. Right here. Like that. And then we need this seared tank. Now, I don't know if I have to place that right next to it, or can I just, like, if I wanted to, just have two pouring spouts right here and then have the tank in the back. Alright, let's try it. And then that way we can kind of hide the ender tank as well. Like this. Discharge it. There we go. Ow, it's hot already. Okay, so it's reading it. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. So, smeltery. No, 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 no. That would have been bad. Smeltery drains. Okay. I wonder if... I don't think I can place one right in the corner. I don't know. It looked kind of goofy anyway. So let's just go ahead and do that. And then... we'll do this one. And this one. There we go. And then over... nope, that's four in it. That's all we got. Yep. Okay. Underneath this one, we'll have the basin, a table, 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 like that, and these here. Okay, so I think I have these up four, so one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. think this would be easier if I was on hover mode anyway. Instead of just jumping around all over the place. There we go. I may not have that right, but let's try it. So, seared windows. Let's do these in front of the smelters, or the drains here where we pour everything. And same way with here. I should have grabbed the rest of them I had back at the base. So that we get this thing done. And the glass, I want to put it right here. And let's do some right here. Should have enough, yeah. Yep. And then on the back, how many of those we got? One. Dang it. Two, three. Let's go one, two, and then that. Okay, sure, whatever. That completes it anyway. So these chests, I do believe, let's go ahead and set these. Let's set two right here, and they're backwards. Yep, they're going to be backwards. And I didn't bring my wrench. Crap, I'll have to turn those around later. Okay. So they're actually facing this way, which ain't too bad. This one. And this one. I don't know why that opens that bottom one. I'm holding shift. That one there. That one. And let's see. Let's do the other two right here, just like the other side. Okay, so that takes care of that. Now the forge, the tool forge, I want to put right here in the center, so that when we cast a tool, we can put it right here and make whatever we need to. The pattern chest is part of the wooden part, and I'll probably, I don't know, I might do something with the villagers around here. Have like a little stall for them so we can greet them on the way by and say, hello! Hello, villagers! Okay, well, there we are. Got that up and running at least. And let's show around a little bit here. In this other spot, I put a nice little window in here. Man, it looks cool, don't it? This place is awesome. But the worst thing about this place, which isn't that bad now, is that it doesn't have any ores. It has skystone and amethyst, which amethyst is pretty valuable. But you couldn't just like start off living here. You would actually, like, I've ran three quarries. I know I Will's ran at least two, maybe three. So we have enough stuff to keep us going for a long time. And then if we have to make a quarry, we'll have to go back to the overworld. So this spot over here, I was thinking how it looks, you know, it's all lit up and looks kind of cool. Like right there on that point, doing something there. I just can't think of what right now, but maybe the enchanting table we can put right there. And then coming from around this wall here down to over here, which it's a little dark, and you see these clouds, you can walk on them, they're pretty neat. But anyway, he started a little train station, another room over here. I'm not sure if you guys can see or not, but I don't have anything on me, so this is going to be one of the stops on the train. And then go back into the base. I'm telling you guys, this is awesome. Be sure to check this out on your own Feed the Beast stuff, or come to the server. And of course, the only thing you need is the worst part about getting here is the Nether Star. That's about it. But anyway, let's cut this episode here. Got this moved. That's kind of stage one. And looking at moving some of the other non-essential stuff for running the day-to-day base for the time being until we can get fully situated over here. And then this will be our new base of operations. So, I guess I'll catch you guys later. Check us out on Shadecrest.com. Come and hang out. Enjoy the fun. Peace out.